want you to welcome Jim Verplatt of Cadillac. Let's chat.
Okay, let's kick this off.
So, let's talk Cadillac, always on the cutting edge of technology.
You know, absolutely. If you think about connected vehicles, Cadillac started this industry. When we partnered and teamed up and put OnStar's standard equipment into our vehicles, you know, the idea of the connected vehicle was born. And since then, we've been spending years learning about our customers, understanding what they want from technology, what they want from, you know, user interface, what they bring into the car, and we've learned a number of lessons, and it's very simple. Customers want things that are elegant, intuitive, and simple to use. And that's really what we tried to do with Q, and hopefully that video demonstrated to you, that customers really want to bring their technology and have ease of use in everything they do.
And, you know, looking at some of your automotive competitors, probably the biggest challenge is the interface.
Absolutely. We focused on the interface, you know, directly, because we felt that's probably where the biggest game changer can be made. And we're very aware of what our competitors do, whether it's a knob or a button or a mouse. We think this interface sets up to be really the most intuitive and easy to use. And really, our engineers were guided by a Da Vinci observation, that simplicity is the ultimate sophistication.
I have to cut you off because we kept talking about this earlier, and I kept saying, if Leonardo DiCaprio really inspired us. DiCaprio's a real Renaissance man, Jim.
Yeah, you know.
Number of paintings.
Thankfully, we have rehearsals, and you guys won't hear that. But, thank you.
I digress.
Okay, I digress. But really, our engineers took a clean sheet approach. Whether it was the hardware, the connections, all the interactions that drivers and customers have with their vehicle, and then immersed ourselves in our customers' lives.
And truly immersed yourself. One of the most fascinating parts about this is you guys sent people on vacation with customers to really get a hands-on experience.
Yeah, our engineers, I think it was the most fun our engineers had in a long time. They actually went along with customers, whether it was their daily commutes, the errands they ran, even vacations, and they observed them. They watched how they interfaced with the vehicle, with technology, what they brought in to the vehicle, you know, what buttons they pushed, what did they want to have happen. And we got a firsthand understanding of how they did that and how they interacted with their vehicle and why they did the things they do and how they wanted things to operate. And we took all those results back to our engineering and design center and put them all up on a wall that we called the Affinity Wall.
Which is a little bit low data capture here. I offered Jim a live scribe after seeing this. An intern was not having fun compiling this. I will tell you that right now. Yeah. The Affinity Wall.
Absolutely. See, I mean, you can see all the work that was done. And what those, you know, we had visioning sessions where our engineers, designers, and the whole team could look at all, and we called it the red thread. What were the elements that we saw happening among all those customers? How could we make the system better? How could we solve some of the things that we saw, how they interacted with their systems. And we created 8 distinct personas. And really, when you think about it, those personas run the gamut very broad, from somebody who's very tech-averse to somebody who wants the latest in technology. So when we developed Q, it really is an expression of what our customers want.
And I think that's really the depiction of all these different individuals, from tech-savvy to not tech-savvy, is the real takeaway here, too.
You know, absolutely. Ease of use for those who aren't comfortable with technology was important to us, as well as delivering the most advanced features that would satisfy the tech savvy, like everybody here in the room. And we coined the phrase that Q is as technically sophisticated as you want it to be, but as simple to use as you need it to be. And that was really our guiding influence.
Let's talk about the future. How do you keep up with the demand and customer preferences and keep moving forward?
Well, you know, you asked me earlier, how is Q different? How is it different than our competitors? And really, one area is that it's an open architecture, unlike some of our competitors. It's a Linux-based architecture, runs Java, HTML5, browser-enabled, which gives us the opportunity to keep Q updated and sophisticated throughout its life cycle. I mean, we all know that cars usually last people 3 to 4 to 5 years. And this will allow us that the day they turn that vehicle in, the vehicle could be just as technically sophisticated and updated as the day they rolled out of the showroom.
You know, a number of different features. OnStar integration, yes, no?
Absolutely. It's critical for us. I mean, we started with OnStar Our customers expect OnStar to be integrated. So all the suites and services our customers expect from OnStar are fully integrated into the queue system, whether that's turn-by-turn navigation, hands-free calling, or our virtual advisor. So it's all there right in the queue system.
So a lot of people are probably wondering, when do we see queue launch?
Well, for me, not soon enough. But at the LA Auto Show, we announced that queue will first debut in the Cadillac XTS, our new top-of-the-line sedan, and then we'll roll it out across other models in the future. And what I'm really excited to tell you about today is the newest member of the Cadillac family that you see behind me coming up on screen. We just unveiled this car to the automotive press at the Detroit Auto Show just about 2 hours ago. So you're getting to see this vehicle. This is the new Cadillac ATS. It's positioned kind of squarely against the BMW 3 Series type vehicle. And that buyer is very affluent, tech savvy, actually a perfect fit for something like Cube, because this customer, you know, basically born with a mouse in their hand. So we're very excited about that.
And again, going back in on the number of different demographics that you can hit on every side. Excellent. Well, we had a snapshot of the future of Cadillac. Jim, I want to thank you for your time.
Thank you, Katie.
Thank you very much. Sure.